Hello guys, welcome to my channel. So today I will be showing you a video of tooth extraction for maxillary and mandibular premolar. Firstly, infiltrate the maxillary premolar region. So you can see that I have infiltrated the region near the maxillary premolar in the vestibular region. I haven't given any block because it is only a single tooth, and then start infiltrating in the maxillary palatal region. Also, we infiltrate in the mandibular premolar region area in the buccal and the lingual side. So this is a case of orthodontic tooth extraction. So now we take a periosteal levator and then we are going to retract the gingiva. So whenever you retract the gingiva, retract from the mesial, labial and then distal region. Make sure that the papilla is not tear and the gingiva is not tear. What common mistake most new learner make is that they directly put the periosteal in the labial region instead of moving from mesial to distal. So in this way the gingiva might get torn. So always move your periosteal from mesial to labial and labial to distal. In this way we are also loosening the PDL and we are exposing the root region. Same thing is to be done in the palatal region. Go from mesial to labial region and from labial to distal region, and then we will also expose the palatal root for inserting the premolar forceps easily, so that the premolar forceps is accessible and it is visible and it does not lacerate the gingiva. So now you can see that the gingiva has been retracted properly, loosening of the PDL has been done, enough exposure for the root and enough space for the forceps to be inserted. Same in this region, and no laceration has been there in gingiva. Now clean it with cotton. Now take a maxillary premolar forceps and insert it in the apical direction. Firstly, the apical direction is the first movement for any tooth, and then you should always remember that the forceps should be placed in the root and not in the crown. And now give buccopalatal movements, buccally and the palatally, and the last movement is the apical movement. So first and last movement is apical movement for any teeth, and in this premolar we have buccopalatal movements along with first and last apical movement, and we have pulled out the tooth. Now give a digital compression from your fingers to re-approximate the buccal and the palatal plate as the alveolus is expanded due to tooth extraction, and then quickly take a gauze piece and then fold it into smaller parts. And then place the packed gauze into the socket and ask the patient to bite it tightly, tooth to tooth. We do the same procedure for the mandibular premolar. See, you can see I'm holding a periosteal and I'm retracting the papillary region between the premolar and the canine. So this papilla should not be torn, otherwise it will cause sensitivity to the patient and towards the other premolar. And I'm going to expose the tooth in order for the root to be visible. Just like the same procedure like we have in maxillary premolar. Now take the mandibular premolar forceps, and whenever you take out tooth in the mandibular region, always hold the jaw on the other side from your left hand firmly so that it does not discomfort the patient in the joint, and then give the apical movement in the premolar region. See, apical I have engaged, and then bucco lingual movement, slight mesiodistal movement is also required in mandibular premolar, and then the tooth is out. Always remember the forceps should be engaged in the root and not the crown. Okay, so one point to be noted is that do not give digital compression if you are planning to put an implant after a tooth extraction. This is a case of orthodontic treatment. So obviously, the gaps are going to be filled in with the movements of the tooth. Digital compression also give knife edge reach. So do not give a digital compression if you are planning to put an implant in future. And in case if you want to know about the post-operative tooth instructions, what to do after tooth extraction, what to follow, so you can click in the description link below. I will give the link in the comment section. Thank you so much guys for watching my video. Please do like, share, subscribe and comment.